greatest songs ever written, this next one. I remember hearing an interview with Steve Earle, and he was talking about being a young, up-and-coming songwriter doing folk and country type music, and he was talking about a song that went number one, became a big hit, that was 6-7 minutes long, a folk song, and it's called The Wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. And he just said what it really inspired him and all his peers, you know, when every other song that was in the top 10 was, you know, fit radio standard, 3 minutes. And Lightfoot came up with this song, a modern day just folk song that tells a story, and it just connected with people. It's a powerful song, and we're gonna give it our best shot.
anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours? The searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. But all that remains are the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. Lake Huron rolls, Superior sings in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Old Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen. And farther below, Lake Ontario takes in what Lake Erie can send her. But every man knows, as the island boats go, with the gales of November, remember. In a musty old hall in Detroit, they prayed at the Maritime Sailors' Cathedral. The church bell chimed till it rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Kitchigoni. Superior, it's said, never gives up her dead when the gales of November.